North Korea best not make any more threats to the United States. They will be met with fire and fury like the world has never seen. He has been very threatening beyond a normal statement. And as I said, they will be met with fire, fury, and frankly, power, the likes of which this world has never seen before. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
President Donald Trump issues a threat to North Korean President Kim Jong-un, putting the world on edge with the threat of a nuclear war. One thing you could be sure is that there will not be a nuclear war with North Korea. Not yet, anyway. The United States has no strategic gain with attacking North Korea right now. Right now, it's just two leaders seeing who could bark the loudest. Not only that, China said they would get involved siding with North Korea if it comes to that. Trump has some of his cheap suits made in China, so he's not going to mess that relationship up. Not only that, China, if I'm not mistaken, is allied with Russia, and we all know Trump has business dealing with them too. It would be a conflict of interest. One thing you could count on with Trump, business interests before American interests. Besides, that message may not have been intended for North Korea anyway. 4 days after that announcement, the Charlottesville, Virginia protests and riot began. But what does that have to do with Trump's threat on North Korea? Maybe nothing. Let's go back to Trump's announcement and see.
North Korea best not make any more threats to the United States. They will be met with fire and fury like the world has never seen. He has been very threatening beyond a normal statement. And as I said, they will be met with fire, fury, and frankly, power, the likes of which this world has never seen before. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
He uses the trigger words fire and fury twice. If you look up Fire and Fury, it could be traced back to a 1990s miniatures war game. A Civil War miniatures war game. Wait a minute. Isn't that what the protest was about? The Civil War heroes? Probably just a coincidence. They have been building racial tensions for a while with cop killings of black men and women and the Somali cop killing of Justine Damon hoax. You don't hear much about that anymore. And the upcoming fight of Mayweather and McGregor. If you don't know by now, that fight is racially charged, planned, and in my opinion will be staged for an upset. This fight is scheduled 5 days after the solar eclipse. And speaking of solar eclipse, here's something. The last solar eclipse that crossed the entire US was in 1918. That same year, there was a race riot in Philadelphia. And the following year, Red Summer, where there were several cities having race riot, with Chicago being the well-known. Could history be repeating itself? I don't know. I just follow the patterns. Remember, we could change this reality. We don't have to accept this. 33 days. The magic number 33. 33 days after the solar eclipse is September 23rd. This supposed doomsday event that's taking place from the Book of Revelations. An event that happens every 7,000 years, give or take a few thousand. At least three times during the Great Age. Do you think the people that written the Bible didn't know this? I could tell you what would happen that day. Cosmic-wise, anyway. The same thing that happened December 31st, 1999 and December 21st, 2012. Not a damn thing. Another tactic to keep you frightened and tense. Weak-minded people will fall for this and be the ones to start riots. And while Trump dispatching more troops to North Korea would make it all the more easier to implement martial law if it comes to that. Change your reality, folks. Resist fear. Enjoy the eclipse. Have a great day and thank you for sharing your time with me.